Okay, so I said that I would try to do example problems that might be like a learning objective assessment. So here's the first one, and this is for learning objective one, where you're either going to find the force on a charge due to other point charges or the electric field due to point charges. This particular question asks to find the electric field at point P due to the two charges shown here, Q1 and Q2. So the first thing I need to do is at point P, I want to draw the electric field vector that it would cause. So charge 2 is positive, which means the electric field is going to be pointing away from it. And so if we imagine a line joining Q2 to point P, this is what the electric field due to that charge is going to look like. Now, if I draw the electric field due to charge 1, that's a negative charge, so the electric field will be towards it. So at point P, this electric field is going to be pointing down. Now, I have to figure out how big the electric fields are. So E1 is going to be K Q1 over R1 squared. I'm just going to use 9 times 10 to the ninth. The charge Q1, this is also like the force problems where we're just going to use the magnitude of the charge. I already used the sign of the charge to draw the vector, so I only need to know how big it is now. So I'm going to do 5 nanocoulombs. A nanocoulomb is 10 to the minus 9, and the distance is 4 centimeters. So that electric field has a strength of 2.813 times 10 to the 4, and the units for electric field are newtons per coulomb. Electric field 2 is going to be KQ2 over that distance squared. And so the charge Q2 is 3 nanocoulombs. And the distance, this actually ends up to be, this is going to be 5 centimeters because this is a 3-4-5 triangle. So our distance is 5 centimeters from Q2 to point P. And so our electric field number 2 has a strength of 1.08 times 10 to the 4 newtons per coulomb. It's a little weaker than E1 because it's a smaller charge and it's further away. Now I'm going to have to add these like vectors. So I'm going to call the total vector E total. The X component is going to be given by the X component of 1 plus the X component of 2. The X component of 1, E1 points in the negative Y direction. It has no X component. And in order to figure out E2, I'd have to take E2. And I'm going to use this angle right here. It would be E2, which is also the same as this angle, is going to be E2 times the sine of theta. If I use my trig, I could say that the tangent of that angle is 3 over 4, and my angle ends up to be 36.9 degrees. So that's just doing a little trig with my triangle. So this ends up to be 1.08 times 10 to the 4 times the sine of 36.9. Something that I neglected to do right here is I should have made this negative because you can see that E2 tends to point into the negative x direction. So I'll put a negative sign there. So ETX ends up to be minus 6.48 times 10 to the third newtons per coulomb. So that's the total X component of my resulting vector. Now I'm going to do the Y component of my total vector, which is E1Y plus E2Y. E1 is in the negative y direction, so this is just minus 2.813 times 10 to the 4. And then the y component of E2 is going to be E2 times the sine, I'm sorry, the cosine of 36.9. So it's minus 2.813 times 10 to the 4th plus 1.08 times 10 to the 4th times the cosine of 36.9. And so this ends up to be negative, and it's 1.949 times 10 to the 4 newtons per coulomb. Now my total electric field, the strength, the magnitude of it, is found by the Pythagorean theorem. Which ends up to be 2.05 times 10 to the 4 newtons per coulomb. And so it's going to be somewhere kind of like down this way is my E total. I'm just sketching it. I'm just guessing. It has a negative Y component and a negative X component. To find the angle that it makes with the X axis, I do the inverse tangent of E total Y over E total X, and that's gonna be 71.6 degrees, but that's my reference angle. I would add it. It would be 180 plus 71.6 degrees measured counterclockwise from the positive X axis, because this is going to be in the third quadrant if we kind of look at the picture, and my angle that I get is going to be positive because both my Y component and my X component were negative. So when I do it on my calculator, I get 71.6. I know that that's the angle that I have to add to 180 to get it into that third quadrant. And this is just an example of what we might have to do. Hopefully this helps.